Now we see these flowers. It's a miracle. It has come out of one seed. Everyone is different, every leaf is different, every color is different. Who does all this living work? Who runs your heart? You ask a question to a doctor, he'll say it's autonomous nervous system. But who is this auto? Who runs your heart? You have to find out who runs this heart. And then we come to the point where we say, we don't know. Then if you go to the science cannot answer many questions. First of all, science is amoral. There's no morality about science. It deals with matter. But when you ask a question, why are we on this earth? Science cannot answer this question. So we have to find out, why are we on this earth? What is our purpose? Have we come here just to live, earn some money, pay some insurance and die? Is that our value? Have we got something more that we have to achieve? So we have to find out that the purpose of our life, why we are here. Now we'll be amazed, understand, that this all is done, as he must have told you, through a power within us. Now this power is your individual mother. Everybody has this mother, and this mother is knowing everything about you. She is the power of mother. Also, Abu Bakr didn't want to talk about women. He fought with Aisha. And also later on, he fought with everyone and he said that women do not count. That's how they put the women on the other side. But Muhammad Sahib respected women out and out. You see, but despite every effort, there is so much of truth in the Quran. First of all, he said that a woman should be married. At that time, there were lots of wars going on. You know, as there were tribes, they even gave poison to Muhammad Sahib. Horrible times. I don't know, he must have a great courage to venture into these Arabic people because they were very, very hot-tempered people. But he said one thing, so many young people are dead. And with these so many young people dead, what should women do? They will become prostitutes, there will be no family life, so it doesn't matter. Have 5 wives, but marry. He didn't want women to become prostitutes. And that's why to establish the sanctity of married life, he said, all right, at that time to marry 5 wives, you can. But there are so many rules and regulations about it. It's not compulsory, because you are a Muslim, you must marry 5 times. Now people have misused all these things to a very great extent, that I'll tell you, in India, we have a problem that women, we have a separate law for Muslims. So their men marry sometimes 4 times, have eight children. So many children. And suddenly they say, talak, 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 finished. These 3 poor women, they are thrown out of the house and the meher is nothing. So just thrown out of the house and they are on the streets, absolutely living on the streets. One day I was traveling, I had gone to one place and I saw on the, our car had stopped because some problem. There was one tap and women were coming to fill the water. Absolutely very poor. I mean, in India I've never seen such poor people. Extremely poor, their children, absolutely bones. In such bad conditions, just couldn't bear it. I felt that an ocean of compassion for them. And I asked them, what is this? How are you like this? Then they told me the story, this is what has happened, and we have in no way help from anyone. So these nonsensical ideas have brought so much of brutality and cruelty to women also. Now, we have to understand that whatever Muhammad Sahib has done is for our good, for our benevolence. All this he told us to be moral people, because we have to be moral. If we are immoral, then our humanity goes away. But he said, you have to have Rahmat, Rahim. All the time he talked about love. Now, so far, we have used hatred in the name of God. Everywhere, we have used the power of hatred. But now the time has come to use the power of love, of divine love. Because you can feel it. It's all around you, and you can feel it. If this realization takes place, you can feel it on your fingertips. This is what in the evolutionary process, now you are human beings, and then just a little jump, just a little breakthrough, and you can feel it on your fingertips. We have so many Muslims from different countries, like Algeria, also from France. As you must have heard about Rouhani Ayatollah, he was surprised the way I gave realization to thousands of people in Paris, and they were of different races, different religions, and different nationality. And he was so sweet. I told him, now you don't have to wear black. Those days are over. Now you have to think of resurrection. So he agreed. I had taken for him a white tunic and a white turban. So he wore it very sweetly and made me wear his turban also very sweetly. He was very, very sweet. And then he was to go to Algeria because they are fundamentalists who were really very cruel. So he asked me, Mother, what should I do? I said, see, now you are protected, you better go. Nothing to worry. He went there, and I'm told he was very successful, and he tried to control the fundamentalists and told them that the Qiyamah time has come now, take to your Qiyamah. That is how he solved the problem. So now we have to live in peace. No more fighting. Look at our children. In the name of God, these are some people who are interested in making money, or getting power and making everybody fight. Now these Bosnia people, I feel so sorry for them. One of them I met, happened to meet. So I asked him, I said, why are you fighting? Forget it. Now, just accept whatever is there. And these horrible, these Croatians and these Serbs are terrible people. You just now give up and don't starve and die. They are not only starving, but they have nothing to eat, they are just frozen. It's worse than gas chamber, because gas chamber in a short time, but 15-20 days they starve and die. Just imagine, only because they are Muslims, they are dying. So the reason he gave me was very bad, because he said, now, you see, we are dying in the name of God, and we will be resurrected. If we are now dying in the name of God, we will be resurrected. Absurd! Of course not. One should not care for this land, this, that. One should care for oneself and for the well-being of your own children. This fighting going on, thank God Arafat had some sense, it's a little bit less now. But still, I would say that people have to take to peace, understand that we have to live in complete joy and happiness. Now this Sahaj Yoga is working in 55 nations. I've never seen these people quarreling with each other, fighting with each other. saying bad things to each other. Of course, I mean, they pull each other's legs, you see, joke and all that. But that's different. It's lot of humor all the time, they're laughing and enjoying. When I was in Russia, they had this problem of the coup. And I asked them, I said, aren't you worried? There is a coup on. So they said, no, mother, we are in the kingdom of God. Why should we worry about this Russia? It's like that. So all this is within your reach, you can get it, and really this will happen. God wants you to be happy. He wants you to be in the kingdom of God. He has created you to give you all the joy and happiness. You know, a father, how he treats his son, does he make him suffer? No. So, God is the father of all the fathers. Why will he make you suffer? Think of that. It's impossible. It's a wrong idea that for religion you have to suffer. Not at all. On the contrary, be kind to yourself. You are human beings and you all can get your realization in no time. Only thing is, it is not meant for stupid people and idiotic people. There are many idiots also. I was surprised from Egypt we had some people who must tell them the story. They were communists. And there were 8 people who came and they said, we want to have a conference on anti-racialism and anti-fundamentalism. And 30 persons can come, you look after our food, everything, put us up in the hotels and we'll have a conference. But then I just thought that this will happen automatically if you become the spirit. Automatically. Because you transcend. You become a different person altogether. So, what's the use of this? I said, all right. I'll say, we'll have a conference on self-knowledge or self-realization or kiyama. They fainted with the word kiyama. Because they were communists, you see. So I said, all right, let us have it on self-knowledge. So what they told me, that if this is the subject, then only 7 people will come and you have to pay for their travel also. So I went to Budapest and I asked, what is this? Why do you want me to pay for your travel and only 7 people will be coming? So you know what they said? This is the stupid part of it. They said that the idea of self-realization is yours, so you must pay. The first one was our idea. These are Egyptians, imagine. I must say Iranians are much better. No, I've never seen such people. That it's your idea to have the self-realization, to you pay for our travel. This was too much. This is not the way that I would like to. You see, so I gave up. I mean, I say I give up. It's primitive. I mean, you have no idea at all that what religion is and what you have to have. How can you say such a thing? I mean, it is absurd. And this absurd idea they gave me, then I gave up. I said, well, finished with the Egyptian communists. And I don't know from where they have learned this thing. That, okay, on principle, you must pay. So, this is what it is. You can understand. I know Iranians are very wise people compared to all other Muslims. But the problem is this fundamentalism that has gone into their heads. Iran is in very bad shape. We have Indo-Iran Shipping Company. My husband was chairman of Shipping Corporation and used to go to Iran, come back. And there's a shipping company working. Then he became Secretary General of the Maritime Organization of the UN. And that's how we came in contact with lots of Iranians and lots of people who were living there. Among all these, I think they are the first ones, because they are also very ancient, very traditional, they will be the first one to take to resurrection, no doubt. And it has worked. I think I'm so happy to see you here. I was always hoping that I'll meet you, and this is your own that you should have. This is your own power, is all your own, and you all should have it. They are very beautiful, nice people in Iran. I have very good experience of them. But only maybe coming to this country, you might have become very materialistic. You were not so materialistic there, that much I know, but I don't know, because coming to this mad country, everybody becomes materialistic. See, it's such a materialistic country that, and people become very superficial. That's also true, no doubt. But even Indians have become materialistic here, you know. It's a funny country, but still, you have emotions, you have feelings for your families. It's not that bad as it is with others. But I must say this country is quite mad in so many ways, you see. For example, some things you will never do. I mean, we Indians can never do some things that they do, like this lady Elizabeth Taylor getting married 8 times. That's all right. Then on top of that, she got married and there were people, 4,000 people went to see her honeymoon. She married a very young person. And there were 10 helicopters hovering on her head. And there were people who were coming down with parachutes to take her photograph. I mean, this kind of a madness, I tell you, Iranians cannot do, we Indians cannot. It is beyond us. I mean, first of all, if she has divorced 8 times, nobody will go and see her because it is inauspicious to see such a person. So it's such a mad place. It's all right, but there are also very nice, sane people. I mean, here lots of Americans are sitting who have got realization, and they don't mind because they are the ones who told me all these things, what stupid things they are doing here. See, it happens. After realization, they start finding their own faults, and they relate to me, "Mother, we are like this, we are like this." So you start seeing, you know, clearly.